Hello, welcome to another Warhammer Fantasy 8th Edition Battle Report. This time it's between Vampire Counts and Demons of Chaos. I'll go over my Vampire's deployment, and the army list will be in the video description. This is 5 Dire Wolves, 40 Grave Guard with great weapons. They're actually skeleton models. I don't have any other skeletons, so 40 Ghouls. I think that's 31 zombies and a necromancer, 32 zombies and a master necromancer. A Terrorgeist with a Strigoi Ghoul King riding it, and 4 Blood Knights, which are Black Knight models.
So on the demon side, starting on left to right, we've got 3 Plague Drones, they've got full command, 25 Plague Bearers, and there's a Herald in there as well, he's my BSB. This is the Chaos Dwarf Magma Cannon model. I'm using it as a Skull Cannon. Because the Skull Cannon's rubbish. Well, the model's rubbish.
It is.
Soul Grinder. 3 Screamers. Great and clean one. This is 20 Blood Letters. I haven't got 20, so there's some Warriors there that are proxying. This is a Herald on disc. And then 5 Seekers. And all units that can, I've got full command.
Undead. Be scared.
So I vanguarded up. So I got the role for Vanguard, and he just tried to charge his Dire Wolves into my Seekers. Let's see what happens.
Need a 14.
So yeah. You need...
A 5.
Yeah. As a primary school teacher, I should know that. So you need 5 on 3 dice, and I'm a demon, so I'm going to stand. Yeah, ooh, he's easy.
Pretty good charge.
5, 6, and then the 5, so he's got easily run aside. That's space. Cool. That's the only charge of turn one, and we'll come back to you after he's moved the rest of his undead. So end of Jack's undead turn one movement. His central units all moved up. I think the ghouls marched.
Yeah, ghouls marched. Zombies marched. They just stopped before
the... They marched, but just stopped before the march. Grave Guard couldn't march because they weren't with the Ranger General, and they've just moved up 4. Blood Knights moved up here. Took a danger terrain test, none died. The ghouls took danger terrain test and 3 of them died. And the scary Terrorgeist man is up here. Magic phase then. So he's got 7. So I've got 2 channels. And I get one. So I've got 5 at the moment.
I've got 3 channels.
3 channels for Jack. Oh, oh, that is not on.
Nick has raised dead with the Master Necromancer.
Okay, do it.
Just zombies, yeah. I don't know if I have to say a lot, but I'm going to. So, 9, 10, 11, plus 4, so 15.
So you got 15, I've got 9.
Yeah, you would have beaten that.
10, 11, 12, 13, 14, yeah. So, dispelled.
Okay, the Master Necromancer Invocation.
Okay.
That's 6 plus, just to bring some class back. So, yeah.
Yeah. So it's got 10. It's got that easily.
So
all the ghouls will come back. Okay. You have to get all the ghouls. So it's got 3 ghouls back from this dangerous terrain.
I think it's 2.
Not these ghoul models. These are the goblins Goblin Town box game.
It took me one evening to paint all of them.
and they're so much cooler than the goblin model and the ghoul models that you can buy from Games Workshop normally. They're all different shapes, they all look cool.
Yeah, and they're one piece as well, you don't have to assemble them.
Yeah, so easy. Right, so now for the zombie ones.
Yeah,
this unit of zombies?
2d6 plus 4, right?
Yep.
Yeah, okay. So that one gets 4, 5, 9.
We'll just remember that and then we'll do it afterwards. So 9 for that one, and this unit.
Double one.
Gets double one.
They
got 6.
Well, I'm going to cast Van Hels. It's not my last spell, but Van Hels on the ghouls. So I can basically reform them.
Yep.
They can't switch reform, unfortunately. But okay, so that's a 6 plus. Oh, who has that? My level 2 necromancer, so I need 4 plus to get it.
Ooh. Done it. that one came up, you were scared. So it's cast.
Okay, so I'm just going to...
I'll let you move that, we'll come back after you moved it. Right, so Jack's final spell.
Another invocation.
Yay!
More zombie skill. So what do you need?
So it's 6 plus, six, I'm assuming, so I need a 4. Again.
Double 6.
Done it.
Got it with
so
6.
So this unit of zombies, 2d6 plus 2, 8.
8 more. And your unit of zombies.
4, 5, 7 more.
7 more.
So it is my shooting phase. So obviously my Terrorgeist is going to scream, and I've got Scabs, Grath on my Lord as well. So let's do the Lord first, since he's the Lord. Bishop 7 again. And my Lord has also got Curse on the Revenant, so he's got plus 1 wound.
Oh, of course he has.
So he'll be getting... So what for him...
Jack. Ass.
So for him it's...
Plus 5.
No, 2d6 is 4, because he starts...
Oh, plus 4, yeah, plus 4.
I think Strigglewood really should start with 4 wounds.
I don't.
Now that I'm using them, obviously. If I was facing them, I'd be like, start with 1 wound.
Right.
So 2d6 plus 4.
Okay, we'll see the roll. Double 1.
10.
Not a 10.
14.
14.
7. Yeah.
So 5, 6, 7. So I best got 7 ward saves to make.
5 plus wards.
Ooh, pretty make good. 4. It's pretty good. So that's 1 that kills 10. 1. That kills the musician.
And then the Terrorgeist. 2d6 plus 6.
Yep.
5, so 3.
So hopefully another one will die.
Hopefully not.
Yeah. Only 7 more saves.
2 saves. I'm going to be attacking both of them because I've got 1 initiative 5. Oh. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11 with the guys on top. It's not bad. So that's 3, 7, and then 4 to wound, 4 to kill. That's 4 dead already.
Wait, so 4 to hit because the weapon score 3, but 6 is a poison. So 1, 6.
Let me check the weapon score then. If you only weapon score 3.
Well, I've got a 6 anyway.
Okay.
So they're poisoned. So.
Oh, right. Okay.
Well done for them. They wiped out the entire die walls, no problem.
Demons of Chaos, turn 1 charges. So yep. We've got a charge by the looks of it.
So the Plague Bearers.
Plague Drones.
Plague Drones, I'm going to charge into these guys.
I thought so. Hope to kill one more, but.
I've got to get. 4. I think that's probably my only charge. I think anything else is in range really. He could be in range, but I want to shoot with him. Yeah, so that's the only charge. So I need 4. You've got a hold. Yeah, easily. 7.
Okay.
So they're going to fly over the building.
So the rest of the demon's movement phase. The cannon's obviously pivoted. Plague Bearers have got the Banner of Swiftness, so they've moved up quite far. To be in the flank of the ghouls. Screamers moved up, everyone else just moved up. And the Seekers have come round to the flank of the Grave Guard. So I want a magic.
Yep. Typically useful phase. 4 and 2 channels. Oh, I've got a channel. Channel. So I've got 5 and you've got 2 at the moment.
3 channels. Yeah.
1 as well, so 5 against 3. So I've got 5 dice, so I'm going to do 1 spell. My Held of Tzeentch is going to cast Infernal Gateway on the Grave Guard over there. I need 16, so I need 14 on 5 dice. Thankfully, what? I get a really good roll. 10, 20, 22.
Yeah, I'm just going to scroll that one.
Okay, so okay. Scroll is out.
Right, shooting.
10 inches from the back. So.
Do you want to mark it? Or just
I'll just roll it and then 8 inches from the back, and then that's going to be 2 inches, so 8 inches from the back, 6, so it's got 18.
So it's got it.
It's got 18. So
what do? We randomise who it hits, I guess.
Randomise who it hits, yeah. So 1 to 4 is the Terror Guide.
Do you randomise or do you hit both? I think it hits both.
Oh, it's template, so
template
hits both.
Yeah,
you hit both. So wounding the Terror Guide are 2.
Nope. Yay!
Wounding the Vampire, yep. No save because his regen doesn't work.
That's alright. That's okay, I've got the Dragon Bane gem. So I think that's a 2 plus ward against flaming. I just need to check the rule on it. Do we have the rule book? I'll come back and say. Okay, so I'm going to roll the 2 plus ward save for my my Strigoi Ghoul King against the Skull Cannon. Oh!
He fails!
Right. What a waste of 5 points.
Oh,
2 wounds. Oh, thank God for
two
that. Okay. Well, you got very lucky with Terrorgeist, and I got unlucky to lose 2 wounds then, but I think the luck is on my side there. Okay, so the Salt Grinder is now shooting its. Is it Flame Bombardment?
It's not called Flame Bombardment, this one's called.
Pus Bomb.
Pus Breath, something like that. So this is how far it goes. 8.
So it's going to go through all those ghouls and hit loads of them and end up there. So we'll count out the wounds and we'll come back to it.
It's got 9 zombies.
So 2 plus. 2 plus. So 7 zombies dead. 16
ghouls. 16 ghouls.
So that's 9.
There's 7 zombies dead there.
16. So 3 plus to kill ghouls.
Yeah, just lose a bat rank probably.
So it's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13 ghouls dead. 13
ghouls, okay.
That's pretty good.
Okay, so the combat now with the Blood Knights, the Plague Drones which have charged them. So I have to issue a challenge to my Castellan and the Plague Drone champion has to accept. So I've got 4 attacks, strength 5, weapon skill 5, so hitting on 4s against them, I guess.
Yeah,
Mark and Nurgle,
yeah.
Mark and Nurgle. So, 2 hits. And eight. Strength 5.
So, 3's to wound.
4's to wound. Your toughness 5.
I am toughness 5, yeah. 4's to wound.
No two wounds.
So, my champion's attacking back. So, the guy on top's got 2 attacks. They're poisoned, obviously, because they're all poisoned. So, 1 hit.
Four
plus, no wounds. Then the fly is poisoned as well. I've given him poison.
Mm-hmm.
1 hit, 3 plus to wound, 1
okay,
wound.
Okay, strength 5, yeah.
Strength 5, yeah.
So I've only got a 4 plus save. 4 plus save. Come on. No, dead.
So champion's dead.
Champion's dead. So that guy is a champion.
Take him off?
Yep. So yeah, 3, 6, 9. Fours.
Fours and fives.
Four, strength 5 as well.
Oh, yes,
yeah, base strength fours. 5, yeah.
That's not great.
Oh, no, it's more than half. I didn't even have the dice in the field of view.
Fours.
One wound.
So one ward.
Saved. Oh, God.
And then he's got his attack, so the guy on top doesn't hit. And drone. Doesn't hit. So
you charged.
I charged. I caused a wound, and I got a banner.
I've got a banner.
So you lost by 2.
So 2 die.
So 2 die.
Oh, that's bad.
So yeah. So you got 1 guy left.
Yeah. I think we fought Blood Knights against Plague Drones before, and it was similar result. We just got absolutely trounced.
So turn 2, Vampire Counts. Got a couple of charges going off. The Ghouly Ghouls are going to have a go at this thing. For some reason. Why, guys? Why? Look at it. It's huge. So, and the Quave Guard are going to do a charge against the Bloodletters. Does mean they'll clip the Ground Clean one as well.
Doctor
realizes that he has pretty much no choice.
Die now or die later.
Because there is combat units, so they need to. There's a good chance they could kill a lot of Bloodletters. So we'll see. So, Ghouls first. They needed.
12. 12 for both units.
So, what's their movement?
4.
So they need 8.
Need 8.
Which they got it. With a 6 and a 3. We'll move them afterwards.
Okay, and Graveguard same.
Graveguard also need an 8. Which they get. Bum, bum, bum. Da, da. And we'll move those and come back to the rest of them. So last bit of movement. This guy came up here to try and kill the Skull Cannon. Zombies, we actually got to record it after, earlier, they declared a charge against the Plague Drones, but they failed. They shambled towards 3, which is unfortunate because these guys are here. And these zombies moved up 4 as well. On to magic. This is Jack's world. We'll do our channeling. You do yours first. I'll do mine.
Channels.
Again, Jack channels. I will my 2 channels.
Oh, we get both well. Channel both, every turn.
Yeah, we channel every single phase.
Okay. So my level 2 necromancer is casting Van Hels on his own unit.
Van Hels on the unit, that means he can move 8.
Yeah.
Okay. 2 dice. Cast with a 9. I'm not going to spell it, if you can have that. I'm not too bothered about zombies being close to me.
We'll resolve that. We'll let Jack resolve that. We'll come back to the next spell.
Master Necromancer is going to cast Raise Dead.
That's this chumley over here.
Mm-hmm. 5, 6, 7. So cast on 11.
11. So I'm trying to spell that with 3 dice. I'm just going to do that with my. So you got 11.
Mm-hmm.
So I would need 9 if I did it with my each guy. I'll do it with quite anything more easily. So I rolled. So that's gone.
So he's going to try an invocation.
Okay.
So I'll need a
12-inch one.
12. That's going to be almost. In that case, I'm going to do it with him.
Okay. So 12-inch one with this level one.
Yeah.
Okay. Get a miscast. Nope.
No, so he's got 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 14.
14.
So spell that.
Yeah, with authority.
Yeah.
Done. So, that was a pretty poor magic phase, really. You only really got off one spell, which was Van Helsing, kind of moving forward. Didn't get very lucky on the power dice, really, how many you wanted. So, shooting, starting off with this guy's Scabscraft.
Bishop 7.
Yeah.
I have the Aura of Dark Majesty, which is all enemy units with 6 inches have minus 1 penalty to their leadership.
Oh, anyway, so didn't do that for the last one.
It wasn't within 6 inches.
Oh, it was in 8 inches. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so leadership 6. So he's only got 2 wounds now, then?
Yeah, so 2d6 plus 2.
Yep,
for him.
Ooh, 11. So that's
13.
13, so 7 wounds. I've got right here. So 5 plus ward. Yeah, he's dead. Dead, dead, dead. So, undead turn to combat. We'll start off with this one. So he attacks first.
Yep, so 3 attacks. Oh, lost combat, so
one attack. Not friendly anymore. Yeah, yeah. Attacks. So 2 attacks.
I didn't do the nightmare attacks last
time. Yeah. We always forget a few things, at least we're not getting big rolls. So 2 attacks, we'll do attacks over here. No hits.
Probably Nightmare's initiative 2, so they're probably the same as yours. I think it is the same.
Just roll for his attack, I think he can do a 5 anyway.
No,
doesn't hit. So now it's me. Can I hand you that, do you think?
Mm-hmm.
My 2 plague bearers, so 6 is wound, no hits, and then the rot flies. Two hits, threes, 1 wound.
Come on. Survived. Saved. Okay, so I've got a standard. You have a standard,
yes,
but you have a musician.
Now I'm going to be a musician instead.
That's a draw. Okay.
It's a draw.
Nice.
Okay, I'll take that back if you want. We'll go to this one. Now, all my men are attacking before you. You know.
Okay, so we're doing the combat between the Grave Guard and the Bloodthirsters and Great and Clean One. Yep. Great and Clean One's got his Eternal Blade, so he's got like 7 attacks.
7 attacks, they're poisoned as well. Because they're always poisoned. So 6 is kill. So 1 dead.
Oh, that's terrible.
Need 2 more hits. 2 dead, it only kills 2. He was useless.
Reminds me of the last battle.
Yeah. And then the blood letters. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, plus a champion. So 7, 8, 9, 11.
Oh, you need one more, yeah?
Yep. So hitting on threes. 6 is a no armor save. The wound that is. Hitting on threes, that's better. Wounding on fours. And sixes are killing blows, so no armor save. So 1 no armor save. And 4 more wounds where you get. You're there, heavy armor, haven't they?
Heavy armor, so that's 6
plus save against those.
None.
So. 1, 2, that was 5.
5, yeah.
Take out a rank.
He's 6.
You're in Horde formation, aren't you?
Yeah.
So 9.
9. Yeah.
Yep. So they're hitting on. What's their weapon skill?
3.
So hitting on 6s.
So Land of the Barons are hit on 5s.
Right. 1 hit.
1 hit.
Strength 6. So wounding on a 5.
Fives. Nope.
No wounds. Then you've got 1, 2,
7,
3, 4, 21, 5, 6.
22.
Yeah, 22.
Yeah, because I've got a champion.
Take out the 1s and 2s. And then strength 6.
Yeah, so
2. So 2s to wound.
You get your ward.
That's terrifying. lose this.
Twos. That's good.
So 3, 6, 9, 12 wounds. Oops. I got my thunder stomp.
Yeah.
Well, that today. Being good.
What's say today?
Oh, that's pretty good.
Loads of ward saves.
So I lose 6. That's pretty good, actually. So I got my thunder stomp.
Yes.
2. So just to kill, 2 more dead. So just to summarise that combat quickly, basically he caused 6 wounds, he had 2 ranks, a charge and a banner. I had 9 wounds, a banner and a rank, so I won by 1, so 1 of his crumbled. And now we're going to go on to Assault Grinder and the Ghouls. So you're initiative 3, did you say?
Yeah.
So I'm initiative 3 as well, attack at the same time. So I'll do my attacks first, shall I, because I may end up dying. So, your weapon skill? One of your men has to take an initiative test first.
Okay.
They're caught by the Iron Claw rule. Passed. So just 4 attacks. Hitting on, I'm guessing 4, your weapon skill 3.
Weapon maybe. Skill 3, yeah.
So, 3 hits from the Soul Grinder, killing on 2s. 3 dead. 2 lots of 15?
Yeah. So 1 lot of 15, 1 of 16.
1 of 16, so 5s and 6s wound. We'll keep count. So 1 poisoned and 2 hits. So let's keep that one separately because that is actually a wound. So 2 hits.
Okay. So, so you've do got that again.
12 there at the moment, so you'd add 4 more to it. Ooh, that's more wounds this time.
2 hits.
And 2 more hits. So they wound on 6s. Some toughness loads.
Tough 7, I think.
Tough 7.
So it's 4 hits altogether, is that right?
Yeah. They got 5 wounds already and 4 more hits.
Oh no.
4 plus armor first. Makes 3. And 5 plus ward. Makes none. So it's got 7, 2 wounds. I'll put a dice there for a moment. We'll put a cap down. So I got my stomp. 6. 34. Oops. 5, 6, so 2's to kill. That's 5 more dead.
Right, so it's demon's turn 2.
Okay, so I've got some charges. These screamers are going to charge on the side, so they've, I've worked out they'll basically end up with 2 in combat.
Cool.
And then they charge in the rear. They have to make it as well. These guys are going to charge there with them. I'm starting to get a banner of swiftness, so they're going to get a 3 now.
Oh,
so they get charged in front of them. And then I've got 1 more movement left, so I'll do that now, which this guy's gonna fly over here. Ugh, 4 again.
4 for magic.
So there are my 2 channels. Do you want to pass me? Oh, that's a drop dice, isn't it? 1. I've got 5.
No, first, 5 against first 2. Time not to channel.
Just keep going, I've got only got 1 spell I'm gonna cast, so
yeah, I know what that is.
Infernal Gateway.
Yeah.
From that guy onto him. 10, 20, so cast 22.
Okay, good.
Double 6.
Gonna need that irresistible then. Come on. 4.
So let me just work this out.
Okay, so we're doing the strength of the Infernal Gateway.
Yeah, because you have to do strength first, because if I roll 11 or 12 on this, you suffer 3d6 hits rather than 2d6. Okay. Nope, 5. So strength 5. This is the number of hits. 8.
Okay, so we've got to randomise
it. Yeah, so randomise first. 5. So
5 plus would hit the rider.
So those are the rider. This isn't flaming either.
No.
And these are the Terrorgeist first.
Okay, so 5 plus to win the Terrorgeist.
No wounds on him. 4 plus.
Yeah,
on this guy.
5, isn't it? Yeah, 4 plus. Oh, 3
wounds. You got 4 plus region?
5 plus region.
5 plus region.
Right, so I need to make
2 of these.
2 of these. Yep. And then we've got 5 plus regen. Okay.
See what happens.
Yeah!
1 wound.
Okay.
And that's the end of magic.
Warp flame.
Hasn't got warp flame.
Oh, right, okay. Okay, so no shooting, so we're on to combat. Gonna start with the Blood Knight. Okay, so 2 attacks, hit on 4s, 1 hit.
Five F4s.
1 wound.
1 wound. 5 plus ward.
No.
F4 wound.
There.
Right, come on, it's got to hang in there.
So then my riders, hitting on four, six is wound, none.
Noticing a trend with these.
There's a trend here, yeah, not doing so well. And then these ones, six is wound, four is to hit.
Oh, a trend is
one wound, catching one
on.
Wound.
Okay.
Come on. Four plus save.
No!
Okay, well, combat reform.
I can't believe Blood Knights just get smushed by Plague Runs on a regular basis, seemingly. So, okay, so your Herald got D3 impact hits.
Yeah, because of his
roll. Strength 4, I guess.
I don't know what strength he's actually on. Strength 5. Strength 5. So, 2, so 1 or 2, 1 zombie dead. My Herald is going to attack your Necromancer.
Because
he can. So, 3 attacks, your weapon skill, not 5?
No, it'd be 3 plus.
3's to hit. That's poisoned.
Mm-hmm.
2's to wound. 2 wounds. See what you save?
4 plus ward.
4 plus wards.
Oh, obviously next, it doesn't save any wounds. Of them. Jesus. So, I hate 4 plus wards so much.
I'll put that in the back of there. So, actually, these three guys mm-hmm. are also all going to attack the Necromancer.
Yeah.
So 6 is wound, 3 is hit. So 1 wound. 1 wound. Can he make his 4 plus ward?
I reckon he can.
He can.
Yay!
So I'll have 4 plus ward. 2, 4, 6 plus 1 for the champion on the zombies. We'll hit 3s to. Well, any of the 6s?
I don't think so.
Three more wounds.
When we watch it back, we'll know.
Why are you making a save so far? The zombies. They didn't make the save. So let's just take that off. That's 4. We have one back.
Yeah.
Okay, your Necromancer can attack.
Right, let's look at this stats. Probably like one attack.
Do you want me to take your camera?
Yeah, please. Yeah, 1, strength 3, weapon skill 3 attack. So
I'm hitting on a 5?
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. And then the zombie's on 6s.
Yep. 2 hits. So, I caused 6 wounds.
Mm-hmm.
I've got 4 ranks.
Well, the ranks cancel each other out.
I've got an extra rank than you. Oh, of course, yeah, it's 33, yeah, isn't it? Yes, yeah, so the rank done out. I've got a banner.
So you won by 8. So 8 more.
6, 7, 8, yes, 8 more die.
Right, next combat, the Screamers and Soul Grinder versus Ghouls.
So Screamers stack first.
Mm-hmm.
What's your weapon skill? 3.
Yeah.
So 4's to hit. 4 hits. Your toughness 3, aren't you?
Strength 4. Toughness 4.
That was 4. So 4's to kill. 2 dead.
2.
War Beast, yeah, they've got no stomping anyway. So should I do my...
Do the Soul Grinder.
Yeah, do one initiative test for the Core by 9 Claw, because it hits automatically. Passed. So his 4 attacks. 4 hits. Mm. 2's to kill. 3 wounds.
Yeah, but we'll still attack, leave him, so. Don't bother taking any off, because they're probably going to die.
So 1 attack against the Screamers.
Right, so 2 attacks against them. Poisoned.
And 1 hit, if not.
1 hit. No, one. So 1 wound.
I think I have to reroll 1s, don't I? Fits each.
What, ward saves? Oh, yeah, I think you do.
So that's made anyway.
Save, yeah.
So, and then you've got. 1, 2, 3,
4, just 10, so 20 attacks.
20 attacks. So 5 to hit, but 6 is wound.
Oh, it's not 20, is it? It's.
Oh, it's 3 less than that. Yeah, 6 less than that. So. No, not, because they attack at the same time. It's only those guys that have died.
Yeah, but I've already used 1 of the front rank to attack them. So I only get 18.
Oh, yeah.
So, alright, 18, sorry.
Yep.
Right, so 6s.
That's it, just 3 wounds.
3 wounds.
So, 4 plus armour makes 2, 5 plus ward. No, so you suffered 1 wound again. Which we'll do that afterwards. You have to take that second. I've got my stomp left as well. Stomp, 5, 4, 5,
there's already three more and they're dead.
So that's going to kill all of them by the end, isn't it?
Yeah, because I'll flank charge.
Take them all off. Okay.
Yep.
Orbigal's dead, and they managed to do three wounds to the Soul Grinder. Pivoting him around.
Actually, no, I'm not, because I don't think I'm in your front arc.
No, I realised afterwards that there was no need for me to be at that angle in order to scream. I just thought, oh, I'm screaming at the cannon, yeah. I'll face the cannon, but I could have been more that way.
Yeah, where you could charge.
Very, very stupid, wasn't it? Right, this combat, Bloodlet is attacking, 11 attacks.
Threes.
Okay. Strength four.
Fours and four. Sixes and no armor saves. One. So I killed one.
Remember Bloodlet is being a lot better than this.
He's strength five. In the old wars, they were just strength five, now they attack five on the charge.
Okay.
Grand Clean one, he got plus one to his attacks. He's now got six attacks. He's poisoned as well, so six is wound. Nope, but. Quite a lot of hits, at least five hits. Two's to wound. Yep, so five wounds.
Just take off that and one. It doesn't matter about the ranks.
Yep. And then the Seekers, they've got two attacks each. Plus a champion, so that's 11, 6, 7. Threes to hit. That was rubbish.
Hmm.
Well done, girls. Guys, you're homogenous, whatever that is. Fives. One wound, arm piercing. Nope. So one more dead. And then the five steeds.
Poisoned, are they?
They're poisoned, yeah.
Oh, they've got two poisons.
Three, so there's one hit.
So five.
Three wounds. All arm piercing as well.
All armor piercing, yep. My god. I saved one.
So two more died.
Oh god, it's hardly any left.
So your attack's back. You've got it was actually three against him. It was like that. So that's actually just two.
Two.
So six to hit. Right.
No hits.
So then you've got.
I think it was five. Because I get plus one to hit. So one wound. One hit. One wound. Yeah. Okay. Worth.
So then you've got. 2, 4, 6. Do you want to all attack the blood letters or attack them? It's exactly the same.
Isn't it? I could get rid of more. I suppose if I kill them, I get rid of your charge, but I can only kill five. I'll just go for the blood letters, I think.
Cool, I've killed more than that, though. I've killed more than that. You've taken another thing off some of us there. I killed nine.
Yeah.
So just blood letters?
Yeah.
So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Three used to hit. That was good. Two to wound.
Well, we don't want any ones here.
Not ones.
Good.
One. And I got my stomp as well.
Ooh. It's a bit better.
So I lost 3, 6, 8. And got stomp.
I'll take that. Definitely.
Two more dead.
Yeah, so I've lost, but
by how much? Actually. So I win by 5, 6,
which is the back rank.
Which is the back rank.
Cool. Handy.
Okay, so that's the end of the combat. So undead turn 3 movement was relatively simple. This guy had to make his charge in, so we didn't even bother rolling for it. So he's in combat with my herald on disc, and he's moved his necromancer out of this unit. You'll see why. So the magic phase. Jack's roll is.
Good one, 10.
10. Not bad. And
still got 3 channels.
Yep, and I've still got 2.
Channel 1, so I'm 11.
I got 2. No, none this time, so 6 against 11. Okay, so we've got to form the beginning of this magic phase, which is a bit annoying, but never mind. So we started off with an invocation from his vampire 12 inches, which I failed to dispel. Crappy roll. Crappy roll. So he's got his 2 wounds back, because he got 1 for the spell and 1 for the.
Law attribute.
Yeah. And he brought back 6 Graveguard. I'm set on killing these. Right. Next spell. So, get second spell. Got an invocation, 12 inch one with this necromancer, which we cast successfully. I only got 1 dice left, not much I can do about it. It's given the necromancer, the moth necromancer over here, a wound back, and 5 more Graveguard, and then a load of zombies, which we'll do in a minute.
Mm. Yeah. Van Hels with him, his actual spell.
Yep.
On
the Grey God.
Yeah. 6+. 4, 5, 6, 7.
So I need a 4. Nope. Oh.
So I'll give him his wound back. And they've got Van Hels.
Okay. So it's part of the combat phase, because Jack has decided not to scream with this, because he's realised if this guy doesn't kill a model by the end of the game with Scab's Graph, he then dies. So that's quite serious. Very serious. So he's foregone his scream to try and kill my Herald in combat, which he should.
Yeah, I think so. So we've got 8 attacks.
So with the charge. With hatred.
Is it 8? Actually, no, I've got... I think he has 5. Plus 1 for frenzy, plus 1 for charge, so that's 7 attacks.
7 attacks.
7, yeah, with eternal hatred, so
3. So 3 with rerolls.
Whoa!
Which is a good thing, because that's pretty rubbish. Thankfully for him, he gets to reroll those misses. I would love it if you get the same again.
I wouldn't, funny enough. It's a bit better.
So 5 hits.
Strength 5.
3 to wound. 2 wounds only. If I can make one of these saves, Scab's Craft might kill him. He's dead.
Not so rubbish.
No, not so rubbish. Never mind, mate.
Okay.
So moving on to this combat.
So I've challenged with my Master Necromancer, which might seem stupid, but it means I get 3 less attacks against me. I'm not going anywhere fast from there, so I might as well try and survive.
Yep, so my Herald helps accept. He's got 3 attacks. 3 hits. Oh, only 1 wound.
4+4. Fails.
To make, so he's lost a wound. And then I've still got 10 attacks as well in the front because he's corner to him.
Mm-hmm.
So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 for the champion. So 3's hit, 6's would have massively. So 2 wounds and another load of hits. 3's to wound. Ooh. 4 more wounds, so 6 wounds on your zombies. Master Necromancer attacks my Herald. 1 attack.
5.
What's the weapon skill?
3.
Or 6 didn't hit, whatever.
Strength 3.
Toughest 5. Yeah. So 6 is to wound.
Nope.
And then you've got 9 zombies. 1 hit.
Ooh, a hit.
5 to wound. No wounds. So you've lost by, so ranks are the same. You haven't got a standard. So you've suffered 6 wounds, 7 wounds. Our standard is 8, so you lose another 8. So this combat first. So first of all, my Eternal Blade on my Great and Clean one. Oh, plus 1. He's got 6 attacks. So 6 is wound and 3 is hit. 1 wound, so 1 dead and 2 more dead. So he kills 3.
Oh.
It has to be that guy first, actually.
Oh yeah, didn't see him. Okay, so then I'll take...
Then him, yeah. So that's 3.
3 there, yeah.
Blood letters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the champion. So, 5, 6. Champion. 3's to hit. That's pretty good. 4s and 6s and no armor save.
Woohoo!
5 wounds and you get 2 armor saves against that. 2 6+ saves. Nope, so 5 more die. And then my Seekers. Not great roll.
Quite a lot of misses.
And so it's 5 to wound as well, which is the problem. So 5 to wound, this is arm piercing. 1 wound again, that's what I got last time. 6+ armor save. Nope, so another 1 dead. And then the 5 steeds.
The steeds. Ugh.
So just 2 wounds. 6+ save.
Nope. 2 more, so right, you've got to bring that whole rank dice in.
Yeah, so now you attack back. So you've got. It was 3 against the Grey and Clean one, wasn't it? No, 2 against the Grey and Clean one.
6's.
6 to hit.
1 hit.
1 hit. 6's. Oh, that's from Van Hels, isn't it?
Yep.
And 5 to wound.
Nope.
Nope.
I'll just go against the Blood Left again.
Okay. Then I get my stomp.
Yeah. Oh, and champion, so.
8. Yep.
Okay. So 3's with reroll.
3's with reroll. Just a good thing too.
Job, yeah, really cool.
So 3 hits, took the pits out. So 3's again.
Yeah, 1 miss.
And then twos. So that's, that could kill all of them, I think. I think if I get no saves, it'll kill all of them. But I do, so four die. My Thunderstomp. Come on, get a good roll this time. Three. Two die. Right, so you've got four wounds and a banner, and that's it. So you've got, your score is five. I've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12.
13, 14.
I've got another banner here, 14. And you've got five, so you lose by nine, which is less than the rest of the unit.
Okay.
So unit is tabled. Mm.
Okay, so it's demons turn three and charges basically everything apart from the two surviving bloodletters and not trying to claim a charge.
Yeah, these guys have to make it.
So these into the side of the zombies there, they have to go look down there.
Screamers are charging in front of these zombies. Front of the zombies. So they have to make it as well.
Okay. Don't think they'll fit with him there.
No, that's they won't actually, will they?
So you're either going to have to charge him or not charge, or charge something else.
Yes,
yeah, so nothing else you can charge, really.
I'm not going to charge. No, I'm going to charge him instead.
Okay.
Yeah, so they have to make it.
Don't charge him, that's fine.
These guys probably have to make it as well, because then there's 10.
10.
So, yeah, they're going inside of them. He's charging that, he needs a 4.
Do the dangerous train as well.
Okay, he makes it. Just.
Yeah, just about made it. So basically, with my gulping on Terrorgeist, I drank the potion of strength at the start of this turn, hopefully to deter the great and clean one, but Dan did the math and basically worked out it's probably still worth charging him, so unfortunately my ruse didn't work, but at least I'm strength 8 now. So.
Yeah, so my 5 danger terrain tests, 1 dies.
That's what we like to see.
And then his danger terrain test, he's fine. So that's all my charges.
Magic roll.
5. Right, let's not forget the Rain of Hell table this time.
Oh yeah, what's that? I'll just do my channels, I've still got 3.
Which actually, I don't think it can affect anyone. Whatever.
No channels?
No, because it only affects people who are under combat. And all in combat.
And is there any enemies, is it?
Yeah, well, it doesn't affect him because it's not the right law.
Okay.
So, one channel.
Channel?
Nope, so...
So 4v5.
Five, yeah.
Okay, so the one spell was cast on 5 dice, which was Miasma of Pestilence.
That's the bigger version of it.
Bigger version on the Great and Clean one. I used 4 dice to dispel it, but just got a crap roll, so he got minus... I'm now minus D3 initiative and weapon skill, my Ghoul King, and Terror Guys, I guess. So anyone best contact, yeah. So I'm now weapon skill 3, initiative 5. And the Great and Clean one's about to get boosted as well, so
yeah.
It was already going to be pretty dicey. And now I'm hitting on the sixes. So, not looking forward to the combat phase. Okay, so combat. So first of all, the Screamers easily killed the Necromancer and overran. And then combined attacks and Crumble killed 11 zombies from this unit and one, what are they called? One Seeker died.
Yeah, and one died from Danger Terrain as well, it's a bit annoying.
Yeah, so there's only 3 left now, so yeah. So now we're going to go on to the other combat with my Master Necromancer.
2 hits.
Strength?
5.
3s? Oh, we can't kill him.
Saved.
Okay, and then I'll attack back.
Yep.
Miss. Okay, so we'll just do the rest of the combat. I mean, unless all the zombies die or something, it won't be very interesting. Yeah. So,
put it all their
life. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so basically in that combat, there's now 3 zombies left and the Master Necromancer. So, I mean, they didn't even kill that much, but just because Crumble, you killed double, didn't take any wounds in return.
Yeah.
So, now we're on to
this scary one,
the main event.
So, more of my Eternal Blade.
Plus three.
So he's now got...
Is it increase your initiative as well?
Yep.
So yeah, miles higher than mine now.
So his initiative is now, yeah, loads.
Tell me about that. Please tell me you got flaming attacks.
No. So he's now got 8 attacks. First of all, he's got D3 strength 9 impact hits.
Oh yeah, okay.
So D3 strength 9 impact hits. 2.
So I guess you've got a minus there, so...
You gotta get first pass for shooting, so...
Yeah, yeah.
So birth and Terrorgeist. So two is to wound. Two is Terrorgeist.
Regen.
Nope. So I'll count that wound in this. So he suffered two wounds. He's got four of his left and Terrorgeist. It's fine, and I've got my eight attacks. Seven, eight.
So how are you going to split them?
I kind of, because I'm going to kill him with Terrorgeist. He's not going to kill you. I'm going to all of them against your Vampire Lord.
Okay.
So three's to hit.
Two's, I want me some
two's
ones.
Two's to wound. Three wounds, it can kill him.
It could kill him, he's only got three wounds left.
Yeah, so five plus regen.
Come on. Didn't save any regen.
Dead.
Okay.
Boom.
Then the Terrorgeist will all crumble at the end of this.
He can attack back.
He'll attack back, yeah. Two
hits. He's wounded with his strength.
Five.
So wounding on sixes. No wounds.
Nope.
Yeah, so he's going to crumble now because I've charged, caused you two wounds on him, three wounds on him. So he's crumbled and died.
Yeah. Okay, so I've got to do a crumble test for my army, I think, at the end of this turn. Or phase, is it? I'm not sure. I'll look it up.
We'll look it up.
So basically, as soon as I said I need to do a crumble test, I had a look and we realised I've got three zombies and some unknown quantity of zombies there. And there's no point continuing, really, because it's definitely no hope for the undead. Even if he somehow miraculously survives, he's only got one invocation. So, obviously, Curse, I've got three turns left, so they get the points for all the zombies. So, well done.
Thank you very much. Good fun again.
Yeah, that was definitely not a good use of the Terrorgeist, getting him caught like that, I think. Didn't need that.
I think you were hoping the Grand King would be still stuck in combat with these guys.
Yeah, because he just about got out of combat. Yeah, I sort of saw that as a possibility, but thought I need to kill that Infernal Gateway guy. Maybe I should have screamed at him from afar.
Then you always had that risk that if you didn't kill someone with Scouts.
Yeah, but it's good fun though. So obviously we just done a quick tally up of the points. So everything in my army will be dead. So plus 100 for the general, so the total chaos score is 2,599.
Yep.
And undead killed the skull can and the level 2 guy, and then that was it. So
305, so it's a crushing victory.
305, yeah. Because these two guys are hanging out there. So.
Yep.
Yeah, so, yeah. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.